This is one of my RC2014 Mini Retro Z80 computers, shown in a previous video. This computer has its own HDMI small format screen and a CPM operating system and 64 megabytes of compact flash storage. But it's not the computer we will be looking at today, but rather the way it will be powered. At the moment, the power, modest though it is, comes from a USB hub, powering both the screen and the computer. We can see that the computer powers up quite successfully, and outputs to the HDMI screen without problem. As small and portable as this computer is, it still depends on having a power source. As the power is coming from a USB hub, I've been looking at power banks to see if we can drive the system for long periods of time independently of mains electricity. And this is what is currently powering the USB hub, a Jackery 240 Explorer. There are quite a few such power packs out there that can do this, but this is the one I happen to have. We are currently only drawing 15 watts from the power bank, so this model of Jackery could power this system quite easily for more than 10 hours. The power bank can be charged via a solar panel, or via a mains charger, or from the 12 volt output from your vehicle. For output voltages, this model has a single mains socket, two USB 5 volt 2.4 amp sockets, and a 12 volt 10 amp socket. So for these Z80 retro systems, it's an ideal portable power unit, compact and weighs in at only 6.6 pounds. So can we use it to power something larger and more power hungry? We're now going to try powering up a mini ITX board computer mounted in a retro C64 case, again covered in a previous video. This will of course draw more power from the power bank. I've connected the HDMI screen to the USB socket on the power bank, and the power brick for the computer is connected to the main socket. Now, as we power up, we'll see that the power draw jumps up to about 20 watts, and will climb to about 35 watts when the computer is busy. However, the power bank has no problems delivering this load to the system. The Jackery Explorer 240 can deliver 200 watts without any problems whatsoever, and there is our Windows 11 computer fully powered up. So what happens if your need for power is greater than 200 watts? For that, we need one of the larger models. There are two larger models of this power bank with increasing capacity. However, as you would expect, with increased capacity comes a larger size and increased weight. Topping the scales at 22 pounds is the Explorer 1000. This power bank has a capacity of 1000 watt hours and can deliver an impressive 1000 watts. I have used this unit to power my video editing suite, and it did so for the 2 hours I was without power. As you can see, there are two main sockets and a selection of USB sockets, as well as the 12 volt 10 amp socket. This power bank can connect to two solar panels for recharging, as well as charging from the mains via a power brick. So being close to mains power is no longer a limitation for either your retro or modern computer products. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.